none of the things that I've just mentioned got any attention, and the reason is that they were all obscured by the death of John F. Kennedy Jr. First, they tell you all about the cockpit, and oh yes, it was a cockpit indeed. And they tell you about the size and how small it is. I personally am not here to attest to the size of John John's cockpit or John John's John John, but perhaps you could ask the Bessette sisters about that. After all, altitude wasn't the only thing going down on that flight.
Welcome back to ECW. We're going to show you footage of last night at the world-famous Agora Theater in Cleveland, Ohio. Keep in mind, this is fan cam footage now. The Dudley Boys, Bubba Ray and Devon, unfortunately, have put Extreme Championship Wrestling in a very, very compromising position.
Face first into the steel guardrail.
Offense.
those belts onto Monday Night Raw, and the, oh my, thumbtacks! Bulls Mahoney sprinkling thumbtacks on that table! One more taste of the extreme for the Dudleys! Devon with the steel chair!
Biggest misfits and the biggest outcasts this world has ever seen. Goofy guys that wear glasses with tape and tie-dyed shirts. Goofy guys who did it their way. Yeah, we gave our notice. Everybody knows that the Dudley Boys are on their way out. The question is, are we gonna do the right thing by ECW and the right thing for the wrestling business? We're gonna do what we wanna do. The public enemy passed the torch to the gangsters. The gangsters pass the torch to the Eliminators. The Eliminators pass the torch to Sabu and Van Damme. Me and Devon took the torch from everybody. Are we gonna do the right thing? No, we're not. We're doing what we wanna do. We're not doing the job. I'm not putting anybody over. He ain't putting anybody over. We're the greatest tag team that ever stepped foot in an ECW ring, and we plan to keep it that way. And now, we're gonna do something we should have did a hell of a long time ago. We're taking these belts, and we're getting on I-95, and we're heading north to the true city of hardcore wrestling, Stamford, Connecticut. I'm walking in that front door with my brothers by my side and these World Tag Team titles that belong to us. We're gonna step in that elevator and press the number 4. And it's gonna take us straight to the top, to the office of the man that means everything in professional wrestling today. To the office of the man that's going to make the Dudley Boys millionaires. And let us do whatever we please. To the office of Vince McMahon, our hero and our savior. We're gonna take these belts
We're going to lay him down at his feet and climb on to his altar and give him our souls. You people don't deserve to see the Dudley Boys ever again. Me and Devon take great pleasure in taking the greatest tag team that ever lived and bringing it to greener pastures. We are the Dudley Boys. And if you ever want to see an ECW World Tag Team title again, all you have to do is tune in to WWF Monday Night Raw on Monday nights. Now get the hell out of here! It's over! What, you think I'm playing with you, boy? Get the hell out of here! Get the hell out of here! Right now!
WWF with ECW's World Tag Team title belts, but they want to destroy their estranged half-brother, Little Spike Dudley, in the process. The stack tables have been set ablaze. Oh my God.
Acknowledging that Tommy Dreamer was the better man. well. I personally predict they will be WWF World Tag Team Champions. I hope they have a long and prosperous career up there. I hope they never come back to ECW. Meanwhile, the show must go on.